Alliance, the mother of Trooper Cody Thiefel, we lost a year and a half ago. Thank you for being here, and God bless you. Thank you for Cody's service. So the number of police officers who were killed in the line of duty in 2017 was 128. That's a 10% decrease over the previous year and the lowest level in 4 years. That's the good news. Traffic accidents were the leading cause of death in 2017 for police officers. Unfortunately, in 2018, there have already been 53 fatalities of police officers and a 56% increase in firearms-related deaths of police officers in our country. As you know, 2018 started off terribly in Colorado. One deputy slain on New Year's Eve, and then two more shot and killed in the following weeks. In addition, seven officers were wounded in the course of those shootings. One of them, as you know, was our son, Jeff Cully, the Douglas County Deputy Sheriff, who was critically injured in the New Year's Eve shooting. I'm happy to report that he's doing really well and recovering strongly. And in fact, he and his comrades, the three deputies who were injured in that shooting, are all in Washington, D.C. this week with their spouses participating in the National Memorial Service. So quite a blessing to him. There they have seen the name of his colleague, Zach Parrish, added to that wall of honor. One of the spectacles that Jeff would see and that you would see if you were at the National Memorial is the scores of police-escorted buses pulling up to the memorial and the candlelight vigil, full of all of the affected family members of the slain officers. Wives, husbands, children, parents, immediate family members, they're all escorted into the ceremonies on the arms of Honor Guard police officers from across the country and around the world. The emotion of the impact of these deaths and the effect that they've had on those families is overwhelming. When you see it, it floods your system like a tidal wave. Stephanie and I attended Colorado police funerals earlier this year, knowing full well that only by the grace of God and a quarter of an inch, we weren't burying our son. Again, a tidal wave of emotion came over us at each service. What I know that sustains those families in Washington, D.C. today, and what has sustained my son and his injured coworkers and their families and my wife and myself throughout a very difficult year so far, is the love and the support and the prayers of our family, our friends, and the community. The outpouring of love and support for cops in Colorado earlier this year was amazing. In fact, I had deputies telling me that they were having a hard time buying their own breakfast or lunch. My hope that would be that the tragedy that we suffered early this year could be turned into something positive. I hope that the love and support for our local cops is sustained and grows in our communities. I hope that people continue giving our officers a thumbs up, a smile, a thank you for your service upon passing. It's been a really hard few months on peace officers throughout our state. And what is hard on them is very hard on their families. Spouses and kids begin to question career choices. It's like when there's so much tragedy in the news all the time, you begin to think that's the reality. The reality is that we serve amazing communities full of wonderful people, a silent majority of good, and that good outweighs the evil every day, anytime. And that's who we serve, is the good. An outward expression of your love and your support continue to motivate these officers and those families to protect and serve our communities. So please pray for those families. Pray for those officers. Teach your kids to pray for them. I believe there's tremendous power in prayer, and the prayer has helped our family cope directly with the tragedy of Zach's death and the injury of our son and his co-workers. Finally, as a leader in law enforcement, I pledge to continue to strive to give my deputies the best training, equipment, and emotional support possible. And I would ask police leaders throughout our communities and community leaders like council members, city managers, to do the same for their officers. Thank you for coming today to honor those who have fallen and to support those who continue to serve. And thank you for allowing me to say a few.